Super Chat.
I like wrestling wars. I agree with you, Roland. Lesnar and Lynch's return countered CM Punk's return. Goldberg countered Stone Cold. Was Booker T the counter to The Rock? Both men won their first singles titles, TV and IC, in 1997. The bookend versus The Rock Bottom.
Yeah, I don't know if I was the counter to The Rock, but I think we definitely had a lot in common, you know, being on different shows and being WWF and me being WCW at that time. I was able to actually be able to go out and, you know, compete somewhat, so to speak, on that level with someone like The Rock. So in WCW, I guess I was the people's champion in WCW, you know, so there was a lot of combating at that time. I do remember being in the WCW, you know, television room, and they would have WWF on the screen, and, you know, it would be something coming up at the 9 o'clock hour, and, you know, book, you know, get ready, you're going in at 9 o'clock, you know, and I was like, but you think we're going to win the war that way? The stupidest plan in the world to think we can combat their show by watching it, but no advertisement, just have a match. I'm like, it's crazy at that time. But yeah, I can see that.
You know what? Hey, man, it was a crazy time for everybody back in the wrestling wars. I think that there is such a thing as counter programming. Look, did Brock Lesnar's return have anything to do with the potential impending return of CM Punk to AEW? I think that that's a perfectly logical thing to think, right? Yeah. I think it's perfectly logical to think, hey, they got CM Punk coming in. All right, get Brock on the phone. See if he's ready to come back. That makes sense to me. Oh, Becky, Sasha's out? You know, it'd be great. Let's get Becky, right? I think that that's totally a normal thing to do, especially when you're in the midst of battle, like we've been talking about. I think that it's the reason why I like a wrestling war. You always run faster when there's someone chasing you. It's just how it is. When someone is pushing you to be better, you will become better. And for LeBron James, it's chasing the ghost of Michael Jordan, like he's talked about before. That is what pushes him. That is what drives him. If you're WWE or AEW and one show's kicking ass and you're like, man, we can't let them do that, you're going to think of how you counter it. And it was the same back in WCW. I think definitely a certain extent, Booker T was a counter to The Rock. Maybe was that the reason for you doing what you're doing? No, but Stone Cold, Goldberg, I've heard Eric Bischoff say, hey, they both had bald heads and black tights. You think that was by accident? And goatee wasn't by accident.
Yeah, right.
We were trying to. And I remember there used to be this toy store in Baybrook Mall called KB Toys. I don't know if you remember.
Yeah, I remember that. Yeah, yeah.
Okay. And I remember going in there as a kid, right when the late 90s, wrestling super popular. I saw a wrestling doll, one of those wrestle buddies, and it had a bald head, a goatee, and black tights. I thought it was Steve Austin. So that's why I bought it, right? I was a WWF guy. Turned out it was Bill Goldberg, right? If it was a Bill Goldberg toy, I didn't know that. Right. I thought it was Steve Austin.
Yeah.
So, yeah, the counter programming definitely works.
No, I mean, it's a war. I mean, it's definitely a war. And right now with, you know, the bombs dropping on AEW side, you know, with guys, you know, showing up, you know, potentially like a Bray Wyatt, you know, potentially like a Adam Cole, Daniel Bryan. We haven't talked about Daniel Bryan, of course, how big he would be making his, you know, entry into AEW. Yeah, man, that right there, it just lets you know that we plan to run, and we plan to run hard. It's just like that Jamaican track team right now, man. He's smoking, you know, the USA, man. We're like, what the hell's going on, man? We need Carl Lewis back, you know. I'm serious, but it's amazing. Like I say, to see it happening, but to watch it from the outside is actually pretty cool. Also, because like you said, you know, this side is gonna, you know, counteract what this side do. And that right there for me as a fan sitting back and watching, wondering, man, how big can this thing actually, you know, get? Because I remember the ratings, you know, being 3.5, you know, fours, fives, you know, having 5 million people, you know, watching professional wrestling show a week. That right there for me, you know, I don't think we're that far from actually, you know, getting wrestling back to that point. But changing the whole name of the game is something I think AEW is actually doing. And there again, creating that competition is good for everybody.
And like you said earlier about our students and all kinds of pro wrestlers around the world, it's more places to work.
I tell you, man, right now is the, I said it, you know, not too long ago that the independent wrestling world is the biggest it's ever been right now. We got so many shows going on around the world to where, you know, one of my students, I just, you know, was talking to him last week, a couple of weeks ago. I said, how many bookings are you taking a month? And he said, about eight. You know, and I go, eight bookings a month? He goes, yeah, about eight bookings. And I go, wow, you know what I mean? So he's subsidizing, you know, his job, you know, with his wrestling job that he's doing on the weekend, you know what I mean? So he's doing two shows pretty much a week, you know, and that right there for me is pretty incredible for these young guys because we didn't have that coming up. And then it leads to, you know, the WrestleMania weekend, which, you know, WrestleMania weekend is not just WrestleMania, of course, it's every independent wrestling company around. So you know how many independent wrestlers are wrestling that weekend alone? WrestleCon, of course. You got independent wrestlers that show up at WrestleCon and they're famous wrestlers. Independent wrestlers,
yeah,
and people buy their merch. So it has been.
I mean, that's how Young Bucks came up.
Exactly my point. Exactly my point. So right now it's as big as it's ever been, guys. I got a little show. It's called The Indies with Booker T. It airs right here on YouTube as well. Every Thursday, 6 p.m., where I interview the independent wrestlers of the world's guys coming up, and I tell you, man, just to hear their stories is pretty incredible for me because a lot of their stories are so different. They get in this business from literally all walks of life, but the one thing that they all have in common is that they love it and they want to make it to the next level. They want to be great, and that's what the Indies is really all about, seeing these young guys do their thing. And if I can give them the rub, that's you know, That's what I do. That's what I do. So, hey, man, check out the show Thursday, 6 p.m. right here on YouTube as well. And I think you'll like it.
It's going to be great. BT, it's been a phenomenal week and a memorable one for us here at the Hall of Fame. But it is time that we sadly say goodbye to all of our fine folks.
You got to get up out of here, man. I got a golf tournament going on here over the weekend. So I got to work on my swing. And so guys, wish me luck. Bradley, I appreciate you. Guys, out there in the chat, we appreciate you guys. All the super chatters, appreciate you guys.
Super chat.
We out of here, man.